straight ahead on CTV News tonight, counting down to the Thanksgiving holiday.
An annual Harvest Fest is back here at FedEx Field. I'm Katara Jones. I'll have everything you need to know coming up on CTV News.
Good evening, I'm Keisha Buzz with a CTV News update. The cold and wind didn't stop volunteers from passing out Thanksgiving turkeys to local families in need today. As Katara Jones reports, hundreds of cars lined up at FedEx Field for the free giveaways.
I'm at the 19th annual Harvest Fest, which is put together by the Washington Charitable Foundation. I want to show you guys what we have going on here. You see dozens of cars are lined up, and all of these people here are Prince George's County residents. And the Washington Football Team's Charitable Foundation is giving away 2,500 turkeys, along with everything that you will need for a perfect Thanksgiving meal. I'm talking about stuffing mix and other items.
So we're giving away a Thanksgiving feast. We have turkeys, and there's some big turkeys, 23 pounds on up. And we're giving away everything you need for turkey dinner: stuffing, cranberry sauce, yams, potatoes, drinks, everything that one would need for a turkey feast. There's more need now than ever to help families. Everyone should be able to enjoy a meal, especially for Thanksgiving. So we're so blessed to be able to do it.
Well, it's needed sometimes with the economy the way it is, so it just helps.
I don't have to go out to the grocery store and look for money, and I'm very thankful for it. Yes, I am, and she's going to do all the cooking this year. My kids can sit down and have a whole meal, a good one too.
Organizers say they will be giving out about 30,000 pounds of turkey at today's event. Katara Jones, CTV News.
In other news, about one-third of households in Maryland face food insecurity. That's according to the Maryland Food System Resiliency Council. The multi-agency group released its first report earlier this month, which offered more than 20 recommendations to address the issue. One suggestion is to establish funding to help nonprofit food councils. Senator Katie Fry Hester is one of two lawmakers who established the committee.
Just from my perspective here in Howard and Carroll County, when I drive by some of our food pop-up pantries, you know, there are still long lines of cars, you know, every Saturday or whatever day it is that the food becomes available, there are still long lines of cars there. And estimates vary, but I've heard that before the pandemic, there were 665,000 food insecure individuals, and now it's up to 1 million.
The recommendations went to the governor and General Assembly. Here are the latest COVID-19 numbers for our area. The state health department has confirmed 740 new cases statewide. The county's positivity rate is up, but still remains below 3%. It now stands at 2.85%. 16 Marylanders have died of the disease since yesterday. 585 people remain hospitalized. Prince George's police are investigating two fatal pedestrian accidents, including a hit and run. The hit and run happened just before 7 o'clock last night on Medical Center Drive at Shoppers Way in Largo. Investigators say a woman was struck as she tried to cross the roadway. She was pronounced dead at a local hospital. The driver fled the scene. The other incident happened just after 5 o'clock last night in Forestville. Police say a man was hit by an SUV as he tried to cross Marlboro Pike. The driver did remain at the scene. Authorities have identified the victim in yesterday morning's fatal crash in Upper Marlboro. He's 28-year-old Trayvon Monroe of Hyattsville. Authorities say he crossed a double yellow line on South Osborne Road and crashed head-on with a pickup truck. Monroe died later at a local hospital. Anyone with information on the crash is asked to call police. You're watching CTV News. I'm Keisha Butts. Coming up, an unusual NASA mission to target asteroids. Details ahead.
Hi, we're Edie's Angels,
volunteers with the Edith B. Wright Breast Cancer Foundation, encouraging you to do your monthly self-breast examinations.
It doesn't really matter how you do them. You can do them in the shower, laying down, or in the mirror. Just make sure you do them.
Because this is
a serious matter.
I dream of a world that's cancer-free.
In all the old familiar places. this heart of mine embraces all day through. Children's carousel, the chestnut trees, the wishing well.
COVID-19 has changed how we express our faith and gather to worship. We all want to get back to how we pray, how we congregate, how we lift our voices in praise. Now it's time to take the first step that lets us get back to spreading the word without spreading concern. Before we can safely come together, we need the facts. As COVID-19 vaccines become available, you may have questions.
Should I get it?
Is it safe?
Should I wait?
It's okay to have questions. Now get the facts. Learn more at getvaccineanswers.org so you can make an informed decision when vaccines are available to you.
Thank you for staying with us. A Maryland businessman receives major recognition from the governor. Carmen Del Guercio receives the 2021 Governor's Champion of Service Award. Del Guercio is the president and CEO of the Maryland Food Bank. The annual award is given by the governor's office on service and volunteerism.
Under his leadership, the food bank distributed an incredible 80 million pounds of food between March of 2020 and July of this year, which represents an 88% increase over the prior year. As part of our Maryland Unites initiative, food banks across our state stepped up during the COVID-19 emergency in a truly inspiring way to help people in need. And the Maryland Food Bank led that charge.
Del Guercio has been with the Maryland Food Bank since 2016. Former President Donald Trump wades into the Maryland gubernatorial race. Trump has endorsed Republican Delegate Dan Cox in his bid for governor. The former president calls Cox an America First patriot. Cox, a far-right conservative who represents Frederick County, has been an outspoken critic of Governor Larry Hogan. Deadly asteroids may be commonplace on Hollywood sci-fi movies, but in real life, they're quite rare. But NASA is taking no chances. Overnight, the agency plans to launch the Double Asteroid Redirection Test, or DART. DART will test the idea of deflecting an asteroid by colliding with a small moon in its orbit.
NASA scans the skies 24/7, 365 to find asteroids. We know of all the asteroids that could cause like a dinosaur killer type of event, but there are actually asteroids that are about 140 meters or so in size, and those are large enough to cause regional devastation, but we don't know where most of those are. So NASA's looking for them, and if NASA were to find one of those sort of city knocking out asteroids, we'd want to be able to prevent or lessen that impact. DART is a technology that we could use to be able to prevent an impact of that kind of an asteroid. DART is going to be the world's first test of the technology we might use if one day we found an asteroid that was on a collision course with the Earth. This is a test. The asteroid we're testing on does not pose a threat to the Earth and will not after this test. We want to do the test of this technology now before we need it so we can be ready if the time comes.
You can watch the early morning event at nasa.gov/DART. You can also see it on social media at #DARTMission. The launch is scheduled for 1:21 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And still to come, a local business lends a helping hand to families in need. Stay with us for that story.
I'm ambitious.
I will not hide it.
We will not hide it.
We embrace ambition.
Women are made to be ambitious.
I will dream big.
Big without hesitation.
We will take risks.
Not live in fear.
We will rise together.
Rise above the negativity.
No longer will ambition in a woman
be seen as a negative.
Be persistent.
Don't apologize.
Never give up on your goals and dreams.
We will model ambition
for our daughters
and our sons.
I will help women around the world,
the whole world,
to succeed.
You have to persevere.
Women are tough,
strong,
powerful. We have got to be a part of this conversation.
Ambition is feminine.
Ambition is empowering.
Ambition is not a dirty word.
I can think of a lot of dirty words. Ambition's not one of them.
Ambition is sexy.
Ambition is very sexy.
What's your ambition?
To help women build empires.
Help more women run for office.
Empower women financially.
Help women entrepreneurs.
Create powerful images.
Change people's lives.
Fight gender stereotypes.
Equality for all.
For all of us to lean in together.
To transform societies.
Change the world.
Take the stigma out of the word ambition.
Own your power.
Own your power.
Own your drive.
Own your dreams.
Own your dreams.
No judgments.
No judgments.
We own it.
Take the pledge.
Take the pledge.
Take the pledge.
Embrace ambition.
Embrace ambition.
Will you?
Mr. Rogers said, look for the helpers. You can always find people who are helping. Thank you to all the first responders who put their lives in danger to help us when my brothers and sisters and mom and dad and grandpa and grandma need them. We look out for the helpers because they look out for us.
Thank you, first responders.
You know, there's a rewarding feeling you get when you do like, hey man, I just, you know, we carried a lady out of a fire, you know?
This is what I signed up for as a first responder, and this is what I love to do. And I'm gonna continue going to work day in and day out and providing help to those that need it.
Thank you, first responders.
Thank you, first responders. We need you. We wanted to let you know how much we appreciate you. Be safe, look after yourself, and look after one another. Thanks.
Welcome back. A two-vehicle crash in Marlow Heights leaves one man dead. It happened last night just before 5 o'clock on St. Barnabas Road at Larry Avenue. Investigators say a car and SUV collided. The driver of the car was killed. The driver of the SUV was taken to the hospital in critical condition. A local coffee shop is doing more than selling hot java. It's lending a helping hand to help the community, and it needs your help. Vigilante Coffee is collecting donations for refugees at its Hyattsville and College Park locations. The store is teaming up with the Immigrant and Refugee Outreach Center. It's collecting items like socks and diapers and new undergarments. Founder Chris Vigilante says the new business looks for ways to help the community. It's currently donating 1% of its sales.
With IROC, we've been working with them on a donation standpoint, I think for over like a year or two, where we had just sent some coffee, shown some love. And then as we saw some of their initiatives take place, specifically around the assistance of Afghan refugees arriving, that seemed right up our alley and a natural partnership.
Vigilante Coffee is accepting the donations until December 19th. Turning to the weather forecast, tonight clear and cold with lows around 26 degrees. Wednesday sunny with high temperatures around 48 degrees. Thursday partly sunny and warmer, highs near 55. Friday showers likely, highs around 46. And now for the community calendar, the Montpelier House Museum in Laurel is hosting another artist boutique. That's this coming Saturday, November 27th. Local artisans will feature original ornaments, fiber art creations, and other crafts. The boutique runs from 11 a.m. until 3 p.m. For more information, call 301-377-7817. And that's your CTV News update. I'm Keisha Butts. Have a good night.